verb. Let's review verb, which we actually did a lot with verbs in Latin 1. Because we learned two different systems. We learned the present tense system. And we learned the perfect tense system. Each of those is made up of three different parts. So the present tense system is the present. The imperfect. And the future. The perfect tense system is the perfect, the pluperfect, and the future perfect. The different tense you use is determined by, are you talking about something in the present, in the past, in the future, how your verb is going to end. So you probably remember in Latin 1, you spent a lot of time memorizing this chart. This chart is a must know. It is a must know. And yep, some of that just comes from you memorizing the ending. So remember the present just translates in the present. The imperfect as that was or were-ing. The future always translates as will. What will happen? That makes sense, right? Mm-hmm. The perfect tense always ends in ed. The word have is optional for perfect. Pluperfect, had, ed. And future perfect, will, have, ed. Some of this will make more sense when we actually put a verb in here. So let's take a step back and just think back to Latin 1 at the very beginning when we said, how do we conjugate a verb, right? We made a chart. First person, second person, third person. We had a singular side, right? We're talking about one person. That's what I mean by singular. We had a plural side. You're talking about more than one person. Okay, and we made a chart. So first person is going to be your I, or in the plural, we. You see how you're included in both of those? That's what makes it first person. Second person, think two. You. You, or you, plural, you all. You, plural. Third person, you're talking about somebody. Like somebody that's not there, somebody that's not in the room, somebody you don't know. He, she, or maybe it's not a person, it's an it. In the singular, and then in the plural would be a they, if they're people, or them. Like maybe I said, look at the apples. The apples, look at them, right? So again, one person, or you're talking about multiple people. Remember, there's four principal parts to a verb. Every verb has four principal parts. In Latin 1, we use the first, second, and the third. So, for example, laudo to praise. Laudo, laudare, laudavi, laudatum. Praise. This is what you would see in the back of the book. All four principal parts. They always have this o, are, awi, autum. The first principal part is used for the present tense system. Okay? That's how you find the stem. Every everything before the O would be your stem for the present tense system, loud. Okay, is your present tense system stem. The second principal part, up to this point, hasn't been super important, but the fact that that is an A-R-E tells us it's first conjugation, because it's the verb. Okay, and you're going to have A before your ending. In Latin 2, we're going to see verbs that end in an E-R-E, and you're going to put E's before your ending. Remember that the second principal part always translates as to praise. It doesn't have a subject. It's not conjugated. The third principal part is used for the perfect tense system. Okay? This right here on this side. So first principal part, third principal part. And you find the stem. Your endings need to be attached to that stem, everything before the I. Okay, so let's remind ourselves of this. You use the first principal part. You use the third principal part. Latin 2 has a lot of new verb endings. We have to make sure that we know the Latin 1 verb endings. Otherwise, you're going to get totally overwhelmed with the Latin 2 verb endings. Okay, let's see if we can remember our ending. Present, remember we have our chart, our first person, second person, third person, you have your singular side, you have your plural side, right? That chart goes with all boxes, okay? I won't draw the chart probably for every single box, because it's a little tedious, right? Present, O, S, T, M, U-F-T-I-S-N-T, right? We sing it to that Mickey Mouse song. O-S-T-M-U-F-T-I-S-N-T. Imperfect. Bam. Remember we said Flintstones. Bam, we're in the past. Bam. Bot. Bot. Vamos. Botes. Bond. We pointed out that still have your S, T, M, U, S, T, A, S, and T, right? Or just ba, like gushy. Ba, S, T, M, U, S, T, A, S, and T. So those familiar patterns remain. And then in the future, bo, bis, bit, bemis, bitis, and bunt, right? Bunt, like I'm going to bunt a ball. You still S-T-M-U-S-T-I-S-N-T. Those little triggers, this should still be recognizable as to what person you're talking about, because those endings remain the same. Now, if you have a verb like a mow, for example, okay, you're going to do a mow. We said to find the stem, it's everything before the ending. So A-M is your stem. How did I know to put that A there? Because it's a first conjugation verb, right? It ends in A-R-E. Amo, amas, amat, amamos, amates, amant. I love, you love, he loves, we love, you all love, they love. So that's how you take those endings that you memorize, because the endings mean nothing by themselves, occasionally I would ask you to do a synopsis. And remember, for a synopsis, you just take one piece out. So if I said, do a synopsis for Amo in the third person singular. Okay? You would literally just give me the third person singular of each box. Okay? That's all it would be. So instead of writing everything out, you just get to give me those little tidbits.
Hello.
Hi, Mr.